Hi, today I am going to take you through everything I did to set up my install right after installing Debian 11 with XFCE desktop environment. However, I also made another video on the changes introduced in Bullseye and how to download the correct ISO, because this procedure is a bit different in Debian compared to most other distros. So if you are interested in watching that, please feel free to do so with the link in the top right corner. Also, feel free to like, share and subscribe. First up, as soon as the install was done, I installed the package bash completion, which auto completes commands given in the terminal using the tab key. Why isn't this pre-installed, by the way? Does anyone know? Once that was done, I removed the packages Firefox, CSR and LibreOffice so that I can install the updated versions using maybe Flatpak or testing or something. I will talk about it in detail later. The next thing I did was to replace the, you know, Windows 95 style menu with the modern looking Whisker menu. You can also do this by going to the top panel, right click on the applications menu, click on remove, then right click on the panel, select panel and then add new items and add Whisker menu from the bottom of the list. Then right click the Whisker menu which has been added in the right corner of the panel and click move. And drag it to the extreme left or wherever you want to keep it till a red bar should appear which shows where the menu will be placed. Then you can drop it there. With that done, the next thing I did was to add a keyboard shortcut to open it using the super key or Windows key for most people. I did that by going to the keyboard settings in the menu, searching, going to application shortcuts and then clicking the plus icon. Then I entered XFCE-popup-whisker menu as the command. Then I pressed the super key in the next screen to set it as the keyboard shortcut. Now I installed a few packages that I needed: Flatpak, GNOME software plugin for Flatpak, GVFS Fuse, which is a tool for, you know, connecting and transferring files between smartphones. Another thing which should be installed with at least the XFCE installation. Also installed Drawing, which is all ready to MS Paint. The next thing was Plank Dock. The reason I installed Plank Dock was that I actually wanted a dock, and the one which comes with XFCE, the make-believe one which comes with XFCE is terrible. So I installed Plank, then I set it up as auto-starting in the, as an application with auto-starts in the application auto-start settings in the settings panel. In the command field, I just had to enter Plank. In the name and every other field, you can insert it, whatever you want. Just the trigger should be set to login. Also, I had to disable the shadows in compositor settings in Window Manager tweak settings. Yes. Otherwise, there is a shadow like 2 inches above the dock. Why is it 2 inches above the dock? No idea. Now I set up Flatpak. If you don't like Flatpak, you can skip to the next section. So I added the Flatpak and Flatpak beta repositories, and then I logged out and logged in as it suggested in the terminal when I added the repositories. Then I added Firefox, installed Firefox, and an alternative to MS Office and LibreOffice named only Office. I think it's quite good actually. And I did both of these using the GNOME Software Center, which I usually have a very bad experience with, it, but it seems it has been improved a lot. Good work, GNOME. Also, I recently found out that Google Chrome is available in Flatpak, FlatHub Beta, I think. Yes. Did I say FlatHub? Yes. Anyways. Yes, Google Chrome is available in FlatHub Beta, but I would not suggest using it. Either you can use the vanilla Chromium or you can use the Brave browser instead of Chrome, as they are both open source. Or on Google Chromium if you truly hate Google but still want to use their products. Also, it seems that you need to search for browser to get Chromium on the GNOME software search results. Hopefully this bug is fixed in the next point release. As I said, GNOME software is not that good. The other thing I want to do is go and launch Clipboard Manager. As you would expect, Clipman will help manage clipboard and clipboard history. You can do this by using the clipboard icon, which should now be present on your panel after the first time you launch it. It will also set itself to auto start.
The final thing is that I want to change the login behavior so that I don't need to put in both the username and the password to login. I can see why they would think of username to be sensitive information, but I think having to type both the username and password is an unnecessary slowdown, and I am comfortable with a password as the only line of defense. Viewer discretion is advised. I did this by going to this file, which I must have edited on the screen by now, and commenting on the greet user line, which is also edited on the screen.
Oh, and by the way, the thing I was talking about in the beginning about more updated software. Well, my approach is using Flatpak. If you do not like Flatpak, you can use the newer packages on Debian itself. In that case, you can switch to the Debian testing distribution, which is basically beta version of the next release of Debian. For example, once Bullseye is released, at the time of recording, it's not actually released. It's a few hours away. So when currently Bullseye is the testing release and Buster is the stable release, which means Buster is the actual released version, Bullseye is being developed. Once Bullseye is released, it will become stable and Bookworm will become testing. In Bookworm, all the newest packages will be added. Maybe a week after they are released, the actual software packages are released, they will be added to testing also. So you can have the latest packages without using Flatpak or app images or anything. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe and share and blah, blah, blah.